never knows how you'd come across somebody once in a while you shouldn't have messed with. That's me. Well,
I won't back down. I am not an African American.
You're Oreo cookie, white in the inside and black on the outside.
I don't have an Afro. I have an Amerifro.
Talking that idiotic stuff you talk about, I would slap you.
Go ahead, make my day.
Black as the ace of spades, but 100% American.
Heard around the world by everybody and their mama. The Jesse Lee Peterson Radio Show.
Uniting the races with truth instead of dividing them with lies. We also rebuilding the family by rebuilding the man. I am Jesse Lee Peterson. Welcome to the third hour already. Patrick Rooney is here. You say here, number one on Hot Topics, Barack Obama stole my money. What do you mean?
Well, okay, we all got not a shock, but we shouldn't have been shocked. But
I didn't realize that the payroll tax was going to kick in.
Yeah.
And on the very first paycheck, in the very first week of the very first month of the very first the next year.
Yeah. So we got our money taken out immediately. We immediately have less money in a month in a paycheck. Two of those in a month. You know, a lot of people get paid every 2 weeks, and all of a sudden, all this money's gone.
Patrick Rooney is talking about the payroll taxes.
I was at the bank, and I was telling the guy at the bank about it. Do you know this man took out money? He took money out of your paycheck. And he said he's only going to take away money from the rich, right?
Right, 2%.
Which is wrong anyway. But he lied. He's going to take away money from the worker. So if you're a worker, if you're a producer in any way, he's going to come for you. And that's why I started telling people, even on the street, I call people I know well. And if if they didn't answer, I left them a message, a voicemail.
You left a voicemail saying Barack Obama took money out of your paycheck.
Yes. And yeah, I did. And I said, especially people that I know probably voted for Obama.
Yeah.
And I said, he took money. He lied. He's a liar. And he's taking your money, too.
Apparently, the 2% of the people were not the ones that we were thinking of. It was not. He didn't mean the rich people. He meant the middle class working people are the ones that are going to make up the 2%, including taking money from the rich.
Everybody knows that you cannot make that money by taking from the wealthy. You cannot take from the wealthy and pay for the things that Obama wants to do. I mean, you don't have enough money with the wealthy. The amount that the wealthy gave in this situation lasted, 10 days or something like that?
Yeah.
It was nothing. So after that, all your money is gone from wealthy. You have to go into the bigger amount of the people and take from them if you really want to redistribute wealth. That's the dirty little secret. And that dirty little secret is just becoming known to the Obama voters now. Funny thing is, I saw an article in the Washington Times called Obama Supporters Shocked Angry at the New Tax Increases. And so they thought, these people thought he was just really just going to go after the 1%. And now they're getting hit with these tax increases.
Good for them.
And
they should get screwed.
Listen to some of these online responses from the Obama voters that they found. This one person says, I know to expect between 93 and 94 less in my paycheck on the 15th, wrote the ironically named Romney Lies. So these are people putting stuff online. They're complaining about Obama now.
Right.
And this guy's screen name is Romney Lies. That's hilarious. And then another one said, my boyfriend has had a lot of expenses and is feeling squeezed right now. And having his paycheck shrink really didn't help, wrote someone named Democrat to the End. This is their screen name. Isn't this great? So what happened is in 2009, Obama enacted what they call a holiday on the payroll tax. So payroll tax was a certain amount. He enacted a holiday, but then the holiday was taken. He took the holiday away.
What does that mean, a holiday?
Holiday means they're not going to charge the same payroll tax as they did. It went from 6.2% to 4.2%. But then they pulled it away, and it came back in.
Wow.
Yeah.
But, you know, I have no compassion for the liberals at all because they believed a lie. Again, they knew that Obama was a liar, but they wanted to believe this lie, and they supported him.
They wanted to believe it. They're burning the rest of us right now. I could go into other ones, too. They're pretty funny responses. But some of the people tried to blame Bush again online. That didn't work too well. How many Americans are going to be affected by these tax raises? According to the Nonpartisan Tax Policy Center in Washington, 77.1% of all wage earners. There's an article in Mail Online, which comes from England, which is really good reporting. It said those workers, and this is not just payroll tax, but these are the taxes in general that Obama's putting in. Workers making $30,000 will take a bigger hit on their pay than those earning $500,000 under the new fiscal deal.
Wow. I am not surprised at all. I was surprised it happened so fast. I didn't know, like, just coming right into the new year, the first thing that's going to hit us in the face is an increase in payroll taxes.
It is.
I did not realize that. And another thing that the Obama and his administration and the Democrats do not want to do is they don't want any entitlement reform.
Exactly.
At all. I want to play that song by Andre. Pull up Maxine Waters there, the Wicked Witch from the West. Democrat, been there forever. I want you to hear what she had to say about no entitlement reform.
All right, who's got the leverage in 2 months?
Well, you know, the Republicans are talking about what all they're going to do with these tax cuts. The president has said we cannot cut our way out of a deficit, and he's absolutely correct. The first thing that we've got to do is look at where we still have unfairness in the tax system and make sure that the people of influence, the billionaires and the millionaires and the corporate interests are paying their fair share. And I believe that whether we're talking about the financial speculation tax or the elimination of the carried interest or defense spending, we've got areas that we can look at to get fair share so that we're able to take care of the basic needs of this country rather than going to Medicare and Medicaid and Social Security and focusing on those areas as the only place that we can get more revenue.
Maxine, she talks about fair share. I say let's go back to the fair share. Everybody pays the exact same percent of tax.
Yeah.
Is that fair?
That's fair. Sound fair to me.
That's fair. That's not what we have today. The rich people are paying way beyond their fair share.
Yeah.
And then we have the 47% that the Republicans didn't want to defend the comments are leeches. So how is it? I don't know how messed up in the mind are we in this country that 47% are not paying taxes, okay? And the rich people are paying way beyond their fair share. First of all, if I was a rich person, I'd be out there speaking about this. I'd be getting people on my behalf. I'd be speaking for myself. I'd be getting my rich friends. And we'd be speaking out about this stuff. Why? Because you make a lot of money, you're somehow guilty and you don't want to, like, talk about it. Or like Romney, he had a 13% or whatever tax rate because he was being taxed on all his investments, he's not getting taxed as a wage earner. Why can't they just step forward? Why are they guilty about that? I don't understand that. Why can't they just step forward and say, I earned it. Here's the spot I'm in now. I'm doing investments. I'm living the dream. I'm doing what I hope that you guys could do, which is go into that investor class of people who pay less taxes and does better. Why can't they just step up and be for America? I don't get that.
You know, another thing that's amazing to me is that people like Maxine Waters and the Fallen Messiah can just lie to the American people, straight up lie, and the people fall for it. I mean, they have no problem with lying, and I know that they know now that the people would fall for it because, look, they re-elected Barack Obama knowing that he's a major liar. They still re-elected him. When I saw my paycheck and realized they had taken out more money, it was like it left me like thinking, wow, it's amazing that they're going to take more money out of my paycheck when the cost of living is going through the roof.
The cost
of living is not coming down at all, but yet they're taking more and more money out of your paycheck.
Well,
and we seem so helpless to it. That's what it's like. It appears that there's nothing we can do about
it. Right. And part of that is to squeeze you on purpose. They want to squeeze people so you don't have extra money. They want people working all their hours so they don't go down to the court, to where the government buildings are, and find out what these guys are doing. I mean, they want you, I'm telling you, they want you higher taxes. They want to regulate you to death.
But that's why we send representatives there who agree with our principles so that they can watch over them. And prevent that. And that's take us to the next
thank
topic.
Thank you. Perfect.
The Boehner betrayal and the mutiny that never happened.
The mutiny, yeah.
Mutiny that never happened. What's that?
Well, the mutiny is the Republicans.
But how is Boehner betrayal first?
Well, the Boehner betrayal is pretty obvious. I don't want to spend a lot of time on that.
All right.
That's just a guy
just for those who made
caving
that
in to Barack Obama every time they get behind closed doors.
But why do they re-elect Boehner knowing that he's a weakling?
Well, let's get into that. It looks like there was an attempt. I was wondering, was there going to be some kind of a coup attempt to get rid of this guy? And I've been yelling from the rooftops for weeks, get rid of this man. He's going to take you down because we have representative government. But if we, the people, are being represented by a weak man, we're in trouble, right?
Yes.
He's our representative.
Yep.
We have to have representative of somebody who's going to represent us. So I've been saying that for a long time. Is there somebody who was going to do a coup of some kind? Well, they did try a coup, as it turns out. I'm looking at an article, Boehner coup attempt larger than first thought. This was from Roll Call. And they said that there was a concerted effort to unseat John Boehner, but it was they called it off a half an hour before the House floor vote. And the reason they did is they called it off is because they wanted to get – they needed 17 votes against Boehner to force a second ballot. That would have made it harder for Boehner to win. They got – they wanted 25 members for some reason. Even though they only needed 17 votes, they wanted 25 members to step forward, some kind of insurance. They only got 24. But they only needed 17.
Well, that sounded like a pretense. They didn't really want it. They only needed 17.
Exactly.
They tried to get 25. Why get 25 if you could get? You only need 17 so you can get the job done.
Exactly right.
So
Jesse,
it wasn't real. That the coup wasn't real.
Exactly right. The Republican members who were supposedly involved with this were Justin Amash of Michigan, Mick Mulvaney of South Carolina, and Raul Labrador of Idaho. And what they did, they also wanted somebody to step forward that would step up against Boehner, okay? They were looking at Eric Cantor, although I've heard that Eric Cantor may not be all that much better than Boehner, not all that trustworthy. But they wanted, some people want Eric Cantor because he voted against against this last deal with Obama. There's also a guy named Financial Services Chairman Jeb Henserding of Texas. I don't know the man myself. They wanted one of those guys to step forward. Now, I'm wondering this too. You got a guy named Paul Ryan who was the vice presidential nominee. Like the guy, good family man.
For the Republicans.
Yeah, a good, tough guy, great on the budget. I'm wondering, during all this talk and during this situation where they could have taken out Boehner and replaced him, why didn't Paul Ryan step forward? In fact, Paul Ryan voted for this plan with Obama,
he
voted for it.
So he was with Boehner on this.
Yes, he was.
So have we heard from Paul Ryan since?
Barely. I heard him on a talk show the other day, and he sounded embarrassed trying to defend himself. Now, Rand Paul voted against it. The gentleman from Florida voted against it as well.
We should have gotten Rand Paul then.
Yeah, we should have got. We need new leadership.
888-77-JESSE. Back in a moment. To the